press my record button.
So you're going to record that with that too? Is that what you're hoping to do?
Right. I'm just going to kind of get this out of the way, but I want to record our conversation as well, just, you know, for myself.
I'll get you my frame, then I'll come in your camera and make sure it's framed up if you're cool with that.
You probably do a better job than I do. That'd be great.
Now come up front. Okay.
Have you been inside to talk to them?
You know, I reached out to them yesterday and they sent me an email kind of stating their position on it. I'm going to see the mayor later because we're going to a transportation unveiling thing. I'll try and get up on that then.
Turn this one just a little bit.
Did you see the video of Dr. Betty Price?
I saw that part, yeah. Yeah.
She was unhappy that I was involved with film because she wasn't at the meeting. Yeah. She would have liked to have.
She tends to not follow the pack, I've noticed. She does things, you know. We did a story last year, but then taking their retreat, they went to some fancy lake.
Okay.
Thing, and she was the only. She was really the only one that was raising to think about it. Why are we owing on spending the money on this kind of stuff?
Mm-hmm. So, good.
Okay. Nydia, we know your name, but tell me anyway. First name, last name, spell both.
Nydia Tisdale.
Okay.
Nydia Tisdale. Okay. Nydia Tisdale.
And you run a website.
I have a website called aboutforsyth.com that I own and blog on. Yes.
Okay. And you also follow the Roswell City Council as of late on the UDC stuff.
Yes, on that topic, I have been following that.
And so, take me to that meeting in February. It was a work session. Everything was going fine for a little while, and all of a sudden, things changed.
I was there all day long. It was a 7-hour marathon work session on a Saturday to discuss the UDC. It started at 11 a.m. and it was to last until 6 p.m. And approximately 5 o'clock, the quorum was lost. And when they realized that, they decided to rename the mayor and city council work session and recall it a staff meeting, which is closed to the public. However, they allow the public to remain, and they asked me to turn the video camera off. The city manager, Kayla, and Mayor Pro Tem, Nancy Diamond, both requested that I turn my camera off because they didn't want it to appear to be an open and public meeting because there was no longer a quorum.
But they weren't kicking the public out of the room. You could have sat there and stayed.
Yes, they invited the public to remain, which is curious because you can't have it both ways. You can't be an open meeting with the public there and then also say it's a closed meeting and your camera has to be turned off. So it was sort of schizophrenic on the city of Roswell's part to have an open and closed meeting simultaneously. It made no sense.
And then after you did turn your camera off, did they discuss anything that would have been controversial to the point where they wouldn't want the camera rolling on?
That's up to the individual to decide. I don't really know. I did turn my audio recorder on shortly thereafter, and I did post that on YouTube with a still shot of just a UDC frame. And they were continuing to discuss the UDC. They were still making changes to the map and doing everything they were doing prior to asking me to turn the camera off. So it was rather unusual. It was quite peculiar.
And so you filed a complaint now with the Attorney General's office. Talk to us about that.
Yes, I filed a complaint yesterday with the Attorney General's office to make him aware of this unusual meeting because I challenged my camera being asked to be turned off.
What do you hope they will do in this case?
I hope the Attorney General will investigate and educate the City of Roswell on whether or not to have an open meeting or a closed meeting and make up their mind. You can't have it both ways.
Now, this wasn't nearly as dramatic as what happened to you in Cumming 2 years ago, but it still illustrates what you think is a miscarriage of the open meetings law.
I agree, yes. The City of Roswell was a little more polite. They didn't grab me and have two armed police officers escort me out of the room. They asked me politely, please, we request you to turn your camera off. And they didn't accost me and grab my equipment and grab me. So they were a little bit nicer.
But then you had another issue most recently at the Forsyth Republican Women's meeting. This was an open candidate forum, I guess people were there, and all of a sudden the secretary comes up to you and she had some choice words as well.
Yes, she told me I was not welcome there. The meeting was advertised in the local newspapers, open to the public, and advertised on their website as this meeting is open to the public. And so I came and I brought my camera to film the candidates and the elected officials and public figures that were there at the meeting. And other media presence were there. There were two other reporters from two local newspapers at that meeting. And they were likewise recording, not with a video camera, but with audio recorders and making notes and writing articles about it. And so she selectively chose me to eject me, not only from the meeting, but from the building, from the restaurant, and threatened to have me removed if I didn't leave. And I questioned her why, and she simply said, "We don't like your strong attack tactics," and asked me to leave. And when I insisted that the candidates want me to record them, she said, "It's not their meeting, it's not their decision, they're not in charge." And she eventually struck my arm and grabbed my camera by the lens, the hood, and I was afraid for my safety and afraid for my equipment. I didn't want her to damage my camera, so I left. You don't have to hit me twice, I'm gone, I'm out of there.
So you filed a police report though?
I did. I contacted the Forsyth County Sheriff's Office the day after and filed an incident report. There is an open investigation. Detective Kim Reed is conducting it. She will be interviewing all the leading attendees and get their side of the story. And I waited a day before filing my complaint. It was late Thursday evening since it happened Wednesday at lunchtime. And I was hopeful that perhaps Ms. Peggy Green would offer an apology, as many had called out for her to do on open Facebook group pages. And no apology was forthcoming, and I felt compelled. I need to act. I need to make the public and law enforcement aware of this incident. It's unacceptable.
And you have since received an apology from the Forsyth County Republican Party.
Yes, Jason Thompson sent me an email apologizing on behalf of the Roswell Women's Club, although he made a distinction that they are not under their control or umbrella. He said that it was unacceptable and unconscionable. And I saw him again last night where I filmed another candidate debate, and he was the moderator. And he again apologized to me and told me that after that meeting they were going to meet and discuss the incident, the Republican Party.
Gotcha. What do you hope comes out of this?
I don't think she should be representing the Republican Party. I think she gives it a bad name. I think people are aghast at what she did and her actions and her words. And I don't think she put a good face on her party. So hopefully they may ask her to sit down from her position, whatever that might be.
Okay. Anything else you want to add?
I thank you for taking this story seriously, because I think people need to be aware of what's happening. I've been verbally attacked and physically attacked because of my camera. I think the city of Cumming and Forsyth County don't like the sunshine of my video camera. I've been called a Nazi agent by the son of a state senator. I've been called a troublemaker by a former Forsyth County commissioner. I've been flipped the bird by a Board of Education school member who is currently in office and is the incumbent and will be serving again. And these actions aren't laughable. They're not funny. They're serious, and they're objectionable, and people don't like it, and they are responding. And I had a lot of supporters last night come up to me and say, I'm very sorry for what happened, and we will take action.
All right, good deal. Stand there for just a second. I'm not sure if this is running today. My producers were kind of on the fence because they had a lot of government kind of stories, so they were going to wait and see. So I mean, it'll run at some point, but maybe tomorrow. So, as soon as I know for sure.
At what hour do you think?
I don't know. Maybe it's either 4, 5, or 6.
Okay.
So once I know for sure, I'll send you an email or text or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah, the producers kind of set their rundown late in the day. It's kind of hard to say.
Thank you.
Sure.
I appreciate
it. Yeah, no worries.
The coverage.
Yeah.
And this is somewhat related to the UDC complaint,
mm-hmm.
because I believe that was another transgression in the process of creating the UDC by not allowing me to film that work session.
Sure.
Another issue I've had is the failure to place proper public notices. And actually, if you have a moment, we might walk inside and see if you can find any public notices, because I couldn't. I walked all through this building, every door around the entire perimeter of it, and could not find public notices.
Wow.
And you're required by the Open Meetings Act to post due public notice.
Sure.
I found agendas. Agendas are not the same document as a public notice.
Public notice, right.
They make a distinction in the Open Meetings Act that you have to post the notice for 7 days, and then also post an agenda. But it's not the same document.
Sure.
Even though you might have similar information in those documents, it's not the same, because an agenda to me doesn't speak to the public. If I'm not keen on government activity, if I see an agenda posted for the mayor and city council a work session on a Saturday, I may not realize that the public is invited.
Right.
It doesn't address me in this public. It doesn't say, you're invited to come to this work session. There are very few people there, in fact. And I think that perhaps the problem is that public isn't informed and not notified.
Yeah,
that this is your meeting. You are welcome. You come on in and sit and watch what we do.
Sure.
And that's why you have to have those magic words, public notice.
Right.
Yeah. That's our invitation.
Seems fair.
That we're welcome to come. So that may be a subsequent follow-up component, which is related, but it's distinct of the openness.
Sure. Okay. All right. Well, good deal. Thanks for making time
for
us. Appreciate it. Sorry I had to push back a little bit.
Thank you. I appreciate it a lot.
Grab my phone real quick. I'm going to get my phone and get some pictures of that real quick.